that can't be any farther from the truth. I think, I've been on this committee for 6 years, and so for 6 years, we have struggled with the budget every year, with declining revenues, and how do we keep your taxes down? That was really a priority that we had. And we're coming out of a recession, we're starting to see some change, but we struggled, we asked everyone in this town who works for this town, that works for us, to do more with less, year after year after year, we've done that. And we've had to raise taxes, we've had to raise it 1 cent or 2 cents each and every year, and we struggle as a committee, you know, to do that. Maybe in the future it's going to get better. We've got warehouses that are coming in, the revenue I think is going to pick up next year, and perhaps there will be more opportunities, but it's not because we didn't want the library, it's because we didn't want to raise your taxes. That's what it was. And it would, if we were to bond for the library, and again, and also in the 6 years, it's always been said that this was a privately funded library, and it really is more in recent months that as we're getting closer, that there's been, we felt a push, I mean, the rest of you might have, felt a push to put more into the library. And again, we struggle with the balance there, the balance of raising taxes. We had a good year this year. We only had to raise it a little bit, and we were lucky, all of us were lucky, because the school brought theirs down, and that really helped. And maybe next year, you know, there'll be additional funds, but it's never been that we didn't want, you know, that we were fighting the library, that we opposed the library. And I just want to make sure that that's understood, because there seems to be,
it's a feeling that I sometimes get. And when we're actually offering a solution to this problem, we have needed to get out of the school for a very long time. We don't meet standards. The school wants us out, whether they're going to say it publicly or not, it's not what they want. And I'm sorry that there's some people in town who don't see that, but we've had needs assessments done. It does not meet state standards. It was in the planning from the very beginning, 1906, that we were not supposed to be. We were in the school in 1906, but to have our separate building. And so we are getting this done and making it happen. The ex-residents of the town that you're feeling the pressure from, not the library board. We're working with you. Okay. So that's what I'm saying. We hear this too. We hear residents come up and talk to me and say, well, why can't the town do more? And I say, we're working. This is where, if you feel that way, come and tell the Township Committee. I guess we get a little frustrated when other projects kind of leapfrog ahead of us, because it has been this way forever. You know, before it was a police station. Oh, no, first affordable housing, police station. No, fire station, police station, affordable housing again, lake. I mean, there's always something. And we're getting this done with the help of everybody in town. So that's where you're getting the pressure.
This, I've been in Cranbury forever too. I've been on the library board, and it's changed and gone back and forth. Funding from the state because of the 08-09 recession, all that changed. So we put the property up, which collectively everyone's paid for. The $475,000 is there. It is unfortunate, I think, from a timing basis that the bids, for whatever reasons, came back at the levels they were. I'd have to say that by November isn't out of the question to find out one way or the other, A, whether this all goes away is fine, or B, that there's going to be more fundraising needed, and then C, that 2018 is a different year. So I understand the frustrations. Some of the things that we have to do, whether it's a fire department or a police station, I mean, those are infrastructures as well. I'm not saying that the library is not a critical infrastructure. I think intellectually it is. So again, it's not like we're trying to drag feet or trying to somehow ruin the chances and make this a harder road to hoe, but that it is a process for us too.
Well, certainly, I guess I'm just letting you know where some of the frustration is.
Sure.
That I'm hearing.
Yeah, I'd just like to talk about our last meeting a little bit. Because you folks came to us and asked us to allow you to proceed. And I had attended a facilities committee meeting maybe 10 days before that request was made. And nothing was said during that meeting about allowing you to proceed without having all the money in hand. Now, Dan and Dave and I have all been involved somehow with the library as members of committees or liaisons or whatever. And if you folks had asked any of us, we would have checked that out and we would have let you know whether there's a possibility. But you blindsided us.
Well, honey, I'm sorry. The library board did not blindside you. It was the comments from the public. The library board is working with you. We did not, it was not anybody from the library board that asked to have the money put up.
It's pressure from the people.
It's pressure from the town, I promise you.
Right, and I'm going to say there's always going to be issues like that that come up, various components. We're at the last 5 yards on this, and I understand that frustration. It is clear that 475 is available. Bids are a little bit higher than, unfortunately, that we were able to start. November, we're going to know one way or the other which road we have to go. And so we're on board with that. I understand the pressure from Board of Ed to have the library out for various reasons. And I think we're there. I mean, the accomplishments so far have been big.
Let's work together to get the funding passed in November. We should all now rally together, get together, and get behind it. I think it's the best thing that can happen to us is that funding get approved. It's almost like I look at this as, you know, you're struggling to get there, it's kind of taking longer than you want, but now all of a sudden it's kind of like, I feel like things are falling into place. And I fully support that funding getting approved. I'm going to vote for it come November because it's the best possible outcome for Cranbury to get that money. If you look at what we pay in income tax out of this town to the state, we get nothing back, and it's a mere pittance. You do the numbers, we send at least $11 million a year to the state. We get nothing. So if we can get that money from the state and help fund the library project, it's a home run for us all. So let's not argue. Let's work together to get that approved. And when we get it approved, let's team together to put together the best proposal possible to make sure we secure the funds once that's approved. That's the best thing we can do now. So we need to look forward. We need to look to the future and work together on that next piece in November.
But that being said, assuming that we get that referendum goes our way, and meanwhile, we're still working with you despite what way that goes.
One of the things that concerns me is that when all this, let's assume that this thing passes on November 11th, I believe that thing is after the expiration of your bid. And one of the things that concerns me is the result of the two hurricanes, Harvey and Irma, that the cost of materials will be very low go up, and therefore when you ask for a resubmission of the bid, the price is going to go up. So I think, so therefore, what you're saying is good, but it may come too little too late.
No, let's not say negative, okay? Let's say positive.
The issue is too timing. Even if we wanted to write the check tonight, we just can't do it for the 27th. Yes, it'll be increases in various levels from, I don't know, from hurricanes or what have you. But that's going to be part of this process. If the funding does go through in November, then that won't be an issue. But also that's where the contingency numbers and the like come in as well. So I'm sorry, but if it goes up to a certain amount of percentages, that's what we're going to have to deal with. We've had to deal with various projects in the same sort of limbo too, when you can't get them done exactly when you want them to get done. They can be more or they can go less. If you have a 2009, I'm not saying that's what we're going to do. Things got a lot cheaper to do in 2010, but it's where we are. It's, enforcement.
Let's work together to get that approved, and then let's work together to secure the funds. That's what we got to think of coming out of this.
Any other public comment at this point? Seeing that, I'm going to close it the second time, right? Good job, yes.